Today, I want to speak about one of my favorite bands inside metal, and I'm speak about Mercury from Denmark. Now, Mercury is not a really black metal band, let's be real, but also there's not a band that many people, I don't understand why many people, especially from the elitist of black metal, hate this band. They play something between black metal and gothic metal and folk music, and this is not something bad about it. First of all, Mercury is a band of the musician behind the band, and the front woman of the band, of course, is Amelie Brown. Amelie Brown, she became famous, first of all, she's the daughter of one of the most famous musicians of Denmark, Mikael Brown. And Amelie Brown became famous as a pop singer when he started her career as a pop singer with the band Amelie Brown. With this band, she made one studio album in 2006, and three EPs. Afterwards, she made an indie rock band by the name X Cops, and she continued this band until 2015. Also, she has connections with Billy Corgan from Smashing Pumpkins. With this band, with X Cops, she made two studio albums. The first, True Calculations, in 2013, and the second, Dangers, in 2014. And afterwards, she made the project Mercury. So, Mercury started in 2014, less or more. And in this project, she took all the music that she liked very much from black metal together with folk metal, and she managed to make a connection between the two. So until now, with Mercury, she made their first EP in 2014, and afterwards three studio albums until now, together with one live album. Also, there are some people that, if I'm not sure, they made another EP in 2018 by the name Juniper, if I'm not sure, but I don't have it. So I will speak about their other works of them and of her by the name Mercury. In the beginning, she took the name also Mercury, and she did want the people know that she is Amelie Brown behind the project. And she started to make these albums by Relapse, their record company Relapse. And always, unfortunately, Relapse, they said, "Oh, this is one woman fronted black metal band," and all the elitists started to be against her with a very, very, very crazy way. And I don't understand this, because she's a woman, because people say that she plays not really black metal, but hipster black metal. No, be really, be really. Let's see. There are other Norwegian bands also from the second wave of black metal that also they don't play true Norwegian black metal. First of all, let's speak about Ulver. Also, Amelie Brown, she says always that Ulver, they're one of the bands that from them she took the whole idea. And the first album of Ulver, also there are people that say that she took ideas from this album to their music, to her music. Okay, no problem. But also here we can find folk metal, folk together with black metal. Or the second album of Ulver, that this is only folk music, and from the fourth album of Ulver and afterwards they don't play even even metal or black metal at all. Or let's speak about Enslaved, or about Borgnagar, two Norwegian black metal bands that they took so many progressive styles in their music. Or let's speak about the band Storm, this project of Satyr from Satyricon and Furnace from Dark Throne, and the album Nordavind. So also, this is an album with folk Norwegian music together with black metal, a great album in my point of view. And also the project of Furnace from Dark Throne, Isengard, and this second album of him, Holmstmørket. Also, here we can find folk music together with black metal. And what about Dodd Hemsgard with this album, 666 International? That this is not the really true Norwegian black metal. Or the whole work of Arcturus and their second album, La Masquerade Infernale. This is even more avant-garde metal, but not black metal at all. And also Garm from Ulver, and also Teloch from Mayhem, and members of Dodenhensgard, they help Emily Brown to this project of Mercury. So why to be so against her? You don't like her music, don't listen to her, but don't come with threats about her life. Crazy, crazy things. Also, she married with Keith Abrami, the drummer of a death metal band from the United States, if not sure, by the name Artificial Brain, and together with him they have a newborn boy in 2019. So, let's come and make a worst to best rank her albums of Mercury. And let's start. In reality, I like every album of her, but let's start. First of all, in the last place, I will put this live album of her by the name Mausoleum. Came out in 2016. Okay, it's a good album. She took the songs, her black metal songs with some folk songs with she played them unplugged and even more with a classical folk style. Okay, it's a good album, but not something great in my point of view. Afterwards, I will put her first EP by the name Mercury in 2014. Here we can find even more black metal elements in her music. It's a great, great first EP. This is the debut EP of her. And afterwards, her first studio album by the name M in 2015. Also here we can find many elements of black metal, and also Garm and Teloch helped her in this album. Some people will say that here we can find that she took things from Ulver. So what? Now, afterwards, her last album of 2020 by the name Folkensand, if I prefer it well. This album is great album, but is not metal at all. Not black metal, not metal at all. Only folk, Scandinavian and Celtic folk music. I like it much, but I prefer that she will continue the connection between the folk and the black metal. And last but not least, in the first place, her second studio album of 2017, Mare Reed, it means Nightmare, great album with a great connection between folk music, gothic metal and black metal together, and I prefer that she will continue in this way. So this is about Mercury. And about Emily Brown from Israel and from Jerusalem, stay metal and stay heavy.